Hey guys, Rick here from the Onside Kick, here to give you my Tuesday video. I wanted to talk to you guys today about something that happened on Monday. Well, it happened this weekend. SportsCenter and everyone talked about it on Monday. Johnny Manziel came out this past weekend and he tweeted, and I quote, "BS like tonight is a reason why I can't wait to leave College Station whenever it may be." And then he deleted that tweet and immediately sent out another one that says, "Don't ever forget that I love A&M with all my heart, but please, please walk a day in my shoes." And I mean, I heard a lot on SportsCenter on Monday where they talked about a lot of things with Johnny Football. This is what I think. First off, you got to think he's a, what, sophomore in college, 20-year-old kid. I'm 23. Some of the stuff I tweet, if I was Johnny Football, it would be on SportsCenter too, because as a college kid, I mean, I bet you whatever he was tweeting about had nothing to do with football. Had absolutely nothing to do with football. It could have done with summer classes. It could have done with his friends, like outside of football. It could have done with just someone at the school, to where he made a point to say, "Ah, man, I can't wait to leave." And I mean, there could have been some football implications. On the other hand, it might have been something where it's like, "God, I can't wait. I can't wait to be a pro." You got to understand, though, he's a 20-year-old kid, and we're treating him like he's a pro. And I mean, yet again, this could go into a whole different argument with how ESPN and SportsCenter kind of put, they talk about what they want. Little example, Stanley Cup Finals going on. They're going to give more attention to LeBron James on an off night, but that's a different story. What I'm saying is, he's a 22-year-old kid. Just forget about it. I mean, yeah, of course, he's Johnny Football. Like Mark Slareth said, probably the only one on ESPN that I think spoke properly about the Johnny Manziel incident was, you got to understand that he's become a celebrity. Johnny Manziel is basically a pro in the college game, and he's not the only one. There's other. Look at the Reggie Bush saga. What happened there? Getting paid to play, and people. The argument: should we pay college kids to play the game of football? And to me, I kind of feel like with college football, just simmer down a little bit. These athletes aren't pros. They're not grown men. They're kids. Me, when I was 20, I was one of the most immature people I know. And it's just, the tweet could have had anything to do with, like I said, school, friends, just people at College Station. I think we're putting too much into it. Point is, Johnny Football loves to play at Texas A&M. He's going to do great things for the Aggies. The Aggies are actually going to be relevant in an SEC that, honestly, before last season, I thought it was like, why are you moving out of the Big 12? Why? Because you're not going to compete with Alabama. Well, Johnny Football proved me wrong. And I mean, he's got a name to himself. He's a celebrity. My grandma always told me something. Mark Slareth kind of said it. I would go more with his than mine. My grandma used to say nothing good happens after 2 a.m. Slareth said nothing good happens after midnight, and to just shut down the Twitter account. That's what you got to do. I mean, especially with college athletes, just shut down the Twitter. Be more watchful for what you put on it. I think Herm Edwards needs to give Johnny Football a little bit of a call. Give him a preview to what the NFL rookies get from Edwards before they come into the league. I mean, if I'm looking at this tweet, I'm not looking that deep into it, though, because, like I said, it could have been anything. He could just be fed up with the people that he's around in College Station and just wants to get away. That's what I think. You guys, tell me down below what you think. Did you think the tweet was that big of a deal? Do you think we put college athletes under too big of a scope? And anything else you want to say, just say it right down below. Also, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe because if you subscribe and leave a comment on any of our June videos on the Onside Kick, you get to have a chance to win an Anthony Rizzo baseball. We'll pick a winner at the end of the month. You could be that winner, so hit that subscribe button, comment down below, check out our other videos, and as always, have a good night, everybody.